Hi, welcome to Vidya Mitra YouTube channel organized by Samagra Siksha Siddhipeta. Today I am going to discuss statistics as a part of bridge course level 4. This is T. Brahma Reddy, SA Mathematics, ZBHS, Ramsagar. After watching this video, the students can able to organize the data in a meaningful way. Students can able to calculate the range of the given data. Students can able to prepare a frequency distribution table. Students can able to distinguish the difference between limits and boundaries. Children, do you know what does statistics deals with? Yes, statistics deals with data. Then what is data? The collected facts or figures with a definite purpose is called data. For example, collecting the marks of math subject in FA1 in a class. There are two types of data. First one is primary data, second one is secondary data. What is primary data? The data obtained directly from the source is called primary data. For example, the number of students taken meals in a school, that is obtained by directly counting the number of students. Secondary data. The information collected from the other sources like registers, which are recorded already. For example, the information of number of students taken meals collected at mandal level or district level. They will collect the information from the school registers. So that is called secondary data. Now let us consider a classroom situation. There is one teacher and a student. Good morning, madam. Good morning, Shiny. Have you collected maths FA1 marks? Yes, madam. Tell me what you have collected. In our class, there are 30 students and the maximum marks are 20 and their marks are shown in the screen. Teacher is saying, what do you know the marks collected by Shiny is called pradata. Can you say the maximum value of the data? Yes, the maximum value is 20. Then what is the minimum value of the data? The minimum value is 3. If you observe this, all the observations are in between 3 and 20. So the maximum value is 20 and the minimum value is 3. The difference between the maximum and minimum value of the data is called the range. So, now can you calculate the range of the given data? Yes. Maximum value is 20, minimum value is 3. So, 20 minus 3 is 17. The students who got less than 7 marks, they will get C grade. And more than 15 marks will get A grade. Then how many of them got C grade and A grade can we say by observing the marks? It is somewhat difficult and time taking. Yes, if we arrange this data in a meaningful way, we can say the answer very easily. Just listen. See, observe the data. The marks of the students are given like this. Now we will prepare a table that consists of three columns. First one is marks, second one is tally marks, third one is number of students. Here the minimum marks is 3, so take marks 3 and count the number of 3s in the data, here 1, here 2. For each one we will take one line, so we have one more 3, so number of students are 3. Like that 5, we have only 5, 7 marks. 6 is not there, so directly go to 7. We have 7, 1 and 2, so 2, number of students are 2. 8, 1, so only 1, 8 is there. 9, 1, only 1, 9 is there. Then 10 is not there, 11 is not there. Then 12, 1, 2, only 2 are there. 13, 3 are there. 14, only 2 are there. 15, 2 are there. 16, 4 are there. 17 is not there, so 18, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now observe the fifth one. Cross the first four lines. That is called the fifth one. And one more, 6. 20. We have 3 20s. So 3. If we add all the number of students, total will get 30. If you observe this table, this table is called ungrouped frequency distribution table. Now we will arrange the students into three groups. Who got 1 to 6 marks as C grade, 7 to 15 as B grade, 16 to 20 as A grade. Now we will take a table, marks, that means class interval, category, tally marks, number of students. Here 1 to 6 categories C, so there are 4 students. 7 to 15, that is B. By observing the previous table, we can say there are 13 students. Now 16 to 20, they are of A category and the number of students are 13. So here also total will get 30. Using this frequency distribution table, we can say that the number of students who got less than 7 marks is 4 and the number of students who got more than 15 marks are 13. So this table is called grouped frequency distribution table. Let us consider another example. There are 35 rice bags with weights in kgs are given below. Observe the values. Here the minimum value is 30 and the maximum value of the data is 85. Now calculate the range. Range is maximum value minus minimum value. Here the maximum value is 85, minimum value is 30, so the difference is 55. Now we have to divide this 55 into some class intervals. Now I am taking it as 6, that is as per my convenience. So we have to take the class length as 10. So I will take the class intervals as 30 to 39. Next 40 to 49, next 50 to 59 and so on. Now observe the data and I prepared a table that consists of three columns. Marks, that is nothing but class intervals, tally marks, number of students. Now I'll take the first class interval as 30 to 39. From 30 to 39, we will see how many students are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, So 6 students are there. In the same way, we count the number of students between 40 and 49. Next is 50 to 59. In the same way, 60 to 69, 70 to 79, and 80 to 89. The total is 35. This table, have you observed this table? Here we are taking the groups. So this table is called as grouped frequency distribution table. Here in each class interval, the least number is called lower limit and the greatest number is called the upper limit. For example, take the class interval 30 to 39. Here the minimum value is 30. So the lower limit is 30 and the maximum value is 39. So that is called upper limit. So upper limit is 39. In the above frequency distribution table, the class intervals are not overlapping. That means in 30 to 39, 40 to 49, 50 to 59, no number is repeating in two class intervals. Such type of classes are called inclusive classes. Now suppose there is a bag which weighs 49.5 kgs. Now we get confused to where should place this data, either in 40 to 49 or 50 to 59. Why? Because 49.5 is not included in both of these two class intervals. So we cannot place 49.5 in either of the classes. So we need different type of class intervals, that is called exclusive class intervals. Here we construct real limits or boundaries. In exclusive class intervals, we calculate the classes like this. The average of upper limit of the class and the lower limit of the next class becomes the upper boundary of the class. The same becomes the lower boundary of the class interval. Let us observe it clearly. Inclusive class intervals. Take a table that consists of 30 to 39, 40 to 49, 50 to 59. Here the classes are not overlapping with each other. So this is called inclusive class intervals. Here the minimum value of this first class interval is called lower limit and the maximum value of that class is called upper limit. Now we will prepare a exclusive class interval using this inclusive class interval. Now observe this formula. Upper boundary in exclusive class intervals comes like this. Upper limit of the class plus lower limit of next class divided by 2. Observe here. Upper limit of the class means from the first class it is 39 plus lower limit of the next class, that is 40. It is divided by 2. So the sum is 79 by 2, that is 39.5. So now this 39.5 becomes the upper boundary of the first class. So you should write as upper boundary. The same becomes the lower boundary of the next class. So this 39.5 also becomes the lower boundary of the next class. Like this. So if we follow the same procedure for all the class intervals, we will get next 49.5. So this 49.5 will become the next class lower boundary. So like this we will write. If we observe this pattern, so there is a difference of 10. So here in the for the first one we will get 29.5. In the exclusive class intervals, the minimum value is called lower boundary and the maximum value is called upper boundary. Now you can see the clear difference between exclusive and inclusive class intervals. Here they are called lower limit and upper limit. Here it is called lower boundary and upper boundary. So this is the process of converting inclusive classes into exclusive classes. By convention, exclusive class intervals, the observation that is equal to the upper boundary, then it is considered in the next class interval. We will look into it deeply. Let us consider some observations 40, 50, 60. Now take the exclusive class intervals as 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. Now observe this 40. Where we should write this 40? Either in 30 to 40 or 40 to 50. Just now above I told it like that. It is considered in the next class interval. Here the upper boundary is 40. So this value 40 is equals to upper boundary of this class. So we should not consider into it. We should take into the next class interval. So this 40 comes to into the class interval 40 to 50. So I will take one tally mark. If it comes to 50 and this 50 is equal to the upper boundary of this second class, so we should not include into this. We should take into the next class. So here comes 50. So take one tally mark. In the same way, 60 also comes into the 60 to 70 class interval. So I will take one more tally mark. So in this way, we will prepare the exclusive class intervals. I hope everyone understood what is exclusive and inclusive class intervals and how to prepare the frequency distribution tables. Now try these problems. Take the screenshot of these two problems and try to solve by taking the help of your friends and teachers. Thank you.